Hello, hello, hello. This is Ash. Hope you're keeping well. And today I'm going to be reviewing my newest additions to my fleet. And these are the Bachmann JGA granite wagons in the Nacco Tarmac livery. We just turn the box around. Here is the JGA Bogie Hopper wagon in the Tarmac. Reference number is 37-328C. All the wagons that I have in front of the camera are exactly the same as they are all in the Tarmac and Nacco branding livery. So I'm only going to cover the one, as I don't really want to sound too repetitive on doing every single wagon in this job lot, as I do aim to build up a rake of 10 of these, and also covering every single wagon would be a bit pointless, as they're all the same basically. There is a nice amount of weight to these, and I have bought these to go with my Class 6s, as in most parts of the UK where these wagons operate, these are usually hauled by a Class 60. Although sometimes they do use Class 66s, of which the operator would be DB Schenker. Although if I'm not mistaken, I think sometimes GBRF use Class 66s to haul these as well. But I'm open to any corrections if I have that information wrong. Right, just going to place the wagon over there. As you can see, there's a brake wheel. Nice amount of detail on the underside. As previously mentioned, decent amount of weight. So, there's only one thing left to do, and that's to test the handling and the performance of these wagons, of which I shall be using a Hornby Class 60. Stay tuned. Right, now that I've set up the train on the test track, and believe me, there is a quite amount of weight to these six wagons, which is why I've chosen to limit the consist to around 10 to 12 units. That will be quite a substantial amount of weight to go behind most locomotives, and some of the older pancake motors probably would struggle to haul a lengthy train like this, and this one is only 6 units alone. Anyways, as I previously mentioned in the last video, this one is 6040. As of yet, I have not done any reviews of this locomotive, as I still need to sort out the CV settings for the cab lights and the engine room lights, as they are not currently functioning on DC mode at the moment, but I will sort all of this out in due course. But anyways, I chose another DB Schenker Class 60, as it is a typical modern image train that you see on the main line in the UK nowadays. And without further ado, let's get the power to the track. This is a GE Sound equipped locomotive, as I am currently experimenting with some sound projects, just to scratch build my own hybrid sound project that I'm currently working on. Anyways, enough of the chit chat, let's get the power to the track. Just what I'll point out, by the way, The locomotive is not struggling to haul the load, as it is a very strong hauler when running under DCC mode, but I believe the CV settings do need adjusting to make the locomotive more responsive on the traditional 12 volts DC. But likewise, that will be dealt with in due course. Also, the lighting kit that I've got on this 6040 is the Express Models lighting kit, of which the work was carried out in early 2013 by Trains for You at Peterborough. And I have to say, it's a very impressive light set, but I will cover more of that when I review this locomotive, which will be when I get access to my DCC train controller, as I will show off the cab lights and the engine room lights. I do like the Bachmann JGA wagons, and there is the Buxton limestone versions available, which are the open bay area top ones, as these ones are the sealed closed top versions. And I do need probably 4 to 6 more of these to make a decent sized train. However, you will see more of these wagons in future reviews, including some additional Class 6s that I shall be reviewing later this year, as I still have yet to review my 6026. Which I believe that is the only one left to review. Although I've had that locomotive over 8 years, I still haven't got round to reviewing it yet. So, that's another one to catch up on. Anyways, I'm going to allow a couple of more passes, and then I'm going to round off the review of the Bachmann JGA wagons, of which these versions are the Tarmac Nacco versions, which is another project train that I'm working on right now. I am over halfway to my target of 10 wagons, so I only need 4 more. So, I'm currently deciding on whether to have a maximum of 10 or to go for a full length of 12. As these wagons do look quite cool behind a Class 60. And there's certainly plenty of weight to go behind them. Well, that concludes my video. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below. And thank you for watching. Have a good week or weekend, and stay tuned for another video coming soon. You are most welcome to rate, comment and subscribe. Until next time, take care everybody, and bye for now.